Mixers, 100 ships a day, lonely sailors pass the time away and talk about their homes.
But there's a girl in this harbor town, and she works laying whiskey down to sip brandy. Fetch another round, and she serves them whiskey and wine. The sailors say brandy, you're a fine girl.
What you're talking about, but I like the way you say it.
My heart is yours, Meredith Quill.
I can't believe I fell in love with a spaceman.
Brandon used to watch his eyes when he told his sailor story. She could feel the ocean falling rise. She saw his raging glory.
Showtime, a-holes. It'll be here any minute.
Which will be its loss.
I thought your thing was a sword.
We've been hired to stop an interdimensional beast from feeding on those batteries, and I'm gonna stop it with a sword.
It's just swords were your thing, and guns were mine. But I guess we're both doing guns now. I just didn't know that.
Drax, why aren't you wearing one of Rocket's arrow rings?
It hurts.
Hurts.
I have sensitive nipples.
My nipples hurt, oh goodness me!
What about him? What's he doing?
I'm finishing this so we can listen to tunes while we work.
How is that a priority?
Blame Quill! He's the one who loves music so much!
No, I actually agree with Drax on this. That's hardly important right now.
Oh, okay. Sure, Quill.
No, seriously. I side with Drax.
No, I understand that. You're being very serious right now.
I can clearly see you winking.
Damn it. I'm using my left eye? Hey, we're not looking at you, buddy.
Oh, that's intense.
Thank you.
should think to be pierced on the outside. I must cut through it from the inside.
Huh? No, no, Drax! Wait a minute! Drax!
What is he doing?
He said the skin is too thick to be pierced from the outside.
But that doesn't make any sense.
I tried telling him that.
The skin is the same level of thickness from the inside as from the outside.
I realize that.
There is a cut on its neck. Rocket, get it to look up.
Just said. But they're worth thousands of units apiece, which is why the Sovereign hired us to protect them. Careful what you say around these folks. They're easily offended. The cost of transgression is death.
We thank you, Guardians, for putting your lives on the line. We could not risk the lives of our own Sovereign citizens.
Every citizen is born exactly as designed by the community. Impeccable, both physically and mentally. We control the DNA of our progeny, germinating them in birthing pods.
I prefer to make people the old-fashioned way.
Well, perhaps someday you could give me a history lesson in the archaic ways of our ancestors. For academic purposes.
I would be honored, yes, in the name of research. I think that could be pretty repulsive. I'm not into that kind of casual...
Oh, please. Your people promised something in exchange for our services. Bring it, and we shall gladly be on our way.
Understand she is your sister.
She's worth no more to me than the bounty due for her on Xandar.
Our soldiers apprehended her attempting to steal the batteries. Do with her as you please.
We thank you, High Priestess Aisha.
What is your heritage, Mr. Quill?
My mother is from Earth.
And your father?
He ain't from Missouri. That's all I know.
I see it within you, an unorthodox genealogy, a hybrid that seems particularly reckless.
You know, they told me you people were conceited douchebags, but that isn't true at all. Oh, shit, I'm using my wrong eye again, aren't I? I'm sorry, that was meant to be behind your back.
Count yourself blessed they didn't kill you.
You're telling me you want to buy some batteries? All right, let's get Baldy to Xandar and collect that bounty.
This road I'd like to tell you about is in my hometown. Make sure to drive the road is calling and take you up or down. From rats on up to bridges, 15 minutes you can fly. Pretty blue lights along the way, help you ride on by. Pretty blue lights shining with heavenly grace, help you ride on by. There ain't no road just like it, anywhere I found. But it's
stuff about my father. Who does she think she is?
I know you're sensitive about that.
I'm sensitive about it. I just don't know who he is. Sorry if it seemed like I was flirting with the High Priestess. I wasn't.
I don't care if you are.
Well, I feel like you do care. That's why I'm apologizing. So sorry.
Gamora is not the one for you, Quill. Shadow. There are two types of beings in the universe. Those who dance and those who do not. I first met my beloved at a war rally. Everyone in the village flailed about, dancing, except one woman. My Ophet. I knew immediately she was the one for me. The most melodic song in the world could be playing. She wouldn't even tap her foot. Wouldn't move a muscle. One might assume she was dead.
That does sound pretty hot.
It would make my nether regions engorge.
Oh, I get it, yes. I am a dancer. Gamora is not.
You just need to find a woman who is pathetic. Like you.
I'm hungry. Have you seen that yarn room? No, it's not ripe yet, and I hate you.
You hate me? You left me there while you stole that stone for yourself. And yet here you stand, a hero. I will be free of these shackles soon enough, and I will kill you. I swear.
No. You're gonna live out the rest of your days in a prison on Xandar. Wishing you could.
This is weird. We've got a sovereign fleet approaching from the rear.
Why would they do that?
Oh, because Rocket stole some of their batteries.
Dude!
Right. He didn't steal some of those. I don't know why they're after us. What a mystery this is.
What were you thinking?
Dude, they were really easy to steal.
That's your defense?
Come on. You saw how that High Priestess talked down. That was... I'm teaching her a lesson. Well, I didn't realize your motivation was altruism. It's really a shame the Sovereign have mistaken your intentions and are trying to kill us.
Exactly.
I was being sarcastic.
Oh, no, you're supposed to use a sarcastic voice. Now I look foolish.
Can we put the bickering on hold until after we survive this massive space battle?
More incoming. Good. I want to kill some guys.
We're not killing anyone. All those ships are remotely piloted.
Exceptionally combustible and could destroy the entire fleet.
Our concern is their slight against our people. We hired them and they steal from us. It is heresy of the highest order.
All command modules. Fire with the intent to kill.
What's the nearest habitable planet?
It's called Bearheart.
How many jumps?
Only one, but the access point is 47 clicks away, and you have to go through that quantum asteroid field.
Well, to make it through that, you'd have to be the greatest pilot in the universe.
Lucky for us,
I am.
Since I was 10 years old.
I was cybernetically engineered to pilot a spacecraft.
You were cybernetically engineered to be a douchebag.
Stop it.
Well, later on tonight, you're going to be laying down in your bed, and there's going to be something squishy in your pillowcase, and you're going to be like, what's this? And it's going to be because I put a turd in there.
You put your turd in my bed, I shave you.
Oh, it won't be my turd. It'll be Drax's.
I have famously huge turds.
We're about to die, and this is what we're discussing?
Son of a...
Dude, seriously!
Hey, let me...
Hold on.
Psylocke, you could do this.
I'm sure he'd be much larger.
That's how eyesight works, you stupid raccoon.
Don't call me a raccoon!
I'm sorry. I took it too far. I meant trash panda.
Is that better?
Oh. It's worse. It's so much worse.
You son of a... I had it with you!
Someone follows you through the jump point.
Set me free. You'll need my help.
Fool, Nebula.
You are a fool if you deprive yourself of hand in combat.
You'll attack me the moment I let you go.
No, I won't.
You know, you'd think an evil supervillain would learn how to properly lie. I bet it's a one-inch man.
Thank you.
always say, you're out of luck until you've gone duck.
It's been some time.
Seems like this establishment is the wrong kind of disreputable.
Dakar!
There's 100 Ravager factions. You just lost the business of 99 of them by serving one.
Please, sir. Please! What you think of me?
So what are you following us for?
Because you're gonna listen to what I gotta say.
I don't gotta listen to nothing. You betrayed the code. Ravagers don't deal in kids.
I told you before. I didn't know what was going on.
You didn't know because you didn't want to know because I made you rich.
I demand a seat at the table. I wear these flames. Same issue.
You made choice like us. But you'll never hear the horns of freedom when you die, Yondu. And the colors of a gourd will never flash over your grave. If you think I take pleasure in exiling you, you're wrong. You broke all our hearts. Pathetic. First, Quill betrays us, and Yondu just lets him go scot-free. Mm-hmm. We followed him because he was the one who wasn't afraid to do what needed to be done. Seems he's going soft.
If he's so soft, why are you whispering for him?
You know I'm right, Kraken.
You best. Be very careful what you say about our captain.
Yondu, Donta, I have a proposition for you.
I hired Yondu to pick you up when your mother passed away. But instead of returning you, Yondu kept you. I have no clue as to why.
Well, I'll tell you why. Because I was a skinny little kid who could squeeze into places adults couldn't have made it easier for thieving.
Well, I've been trying to track you down ever since.
I thought Yondu was your father.
What? Been together this whole time, you thought Yondu was my actual blood relative?
You look exactly alike.
One's blue!
No, he's not my father. Yondu is the guy who abducted me, kicked the crap out of me so I could learn to fight and get me in terror by threatening to eat me.
Eat you?
Yeah.
Oh, that son of a bitch.
How'd you locate us now?
Well, even where I reside, out past the edge of what's known, we've heard tell about the man they call Star-Lord. Let's say we head out there right now. Your associates are welcome. That triangle-faced monkey there. Promise you, it's unlike any other place you've ever seen. And there, I can explain your very special heritage. Finally get to be the father I've always wanted to be. Excuse me. Gotta take a whiz.
Amen.
place.
What are you doing?
Smiling. I hear it is the thing to do to make people like you.
What if you do it like that?
Oh. I was raised alone on Ego's planet. I do not understand the intricacies of social interaction. Can I pet your puppy? It is adorable.
Yes. That is called a practical joke.
Thank you very much.
I just made it up.
Give me a break. After all this time, you're going to show up and just all of a sudden you want to be my dad?
I hear you.
No, by the way, this could be a trap, okay? The Creep Purists, the Ravagers, they all want us dead.
I know, but...
But what?
What was that story you told me about Zardu Hasselfrau?
Who?
He owned a magic boat.
David Hasselhoff?
Right.
Not a magic boat, a talking car.
Why did he talk again?
To help him fight crime and to be supportive.
As a child, you would carry his picture in your pocket and you would tell all the other children that he was your father, but that he was out of town.
Shooting Knight Rider or touring with his band in Germany. I told you that when I was drunk. Why are you bringing that up now?
I love that story.
I hate that story. It's so sad. As a kid, I used to see all the other kids off playing catch with their dad, and I wanted that more than anything in the world.
That's my point, Peter. What if this man is your Hasselhoff? Listen, if he ends up being evil, we'll just kill him.
You're leaving me with that fox?
He's not a fox. Shoot her if she does anything suspicious. Or if you feel like it.
Okay.
Hey, it'll be just a couple of days. We'll be back before Rocket's finished fixing the ship.
What if the Sovereign come?
There's no way for them to know we're here. Let's go.
I'm uncertain about parting ways.
God, you're like an old woman.
Because I'm wise.
Why do you have so much luggage?
I won't go play with my things.
Hope Daddy isn't as big of a dick as you, orphan boy.
What is your goal here? To get everybody to hate you? Because it's working.
For feeling doorway.
I think they have something to do with my empathic abilities.
What are those?
If I touch someone, I can feel their feelings.
You read minds?
No. Telepaths know thoughts. Empaths feel feelings. Emotions. May I?
All right. Yeah, I feel a general, unselfish love for just about everybody.
No. Romantic, sexual love.
No, no, I don't.
For her.
No, that is not... Okay.
She just told everyone your deepest, darkest secret.
Dude, come on, I think you're overreacting a little bit.
You must be so embarrassed. Do me.
I have never felt so
her emotions to some extent.
Yeah, like what?
If I touch someone who is sad, I can ease them into contentment for a short while. I can make a stubborn person compliant. But I mostly use it to help my master sleep. He lies awake at night, thinking about his progeny.
Do one of those on me.
So bad. We got ourselves a pretty good little gig here. This golden gal with quite a high opinion of herself has offered us a large sum to deliver you and your pals over to her because she wants to kill y'all.
Your friend, there's too many of them. He needs my help. If you care about him, you need to get me out of these bonds. They are going to kill him.
I tell you, it was pretty easy to find you. I put a tracer on your ship back there during the war over Xandar.
Give me your word you won't hurt Groot, and I'll tell you where the batteries are.
Lucky for you, my word don't mean squat. Otherwise, I'd actually hand you over.
Otherwise, you'd what?
We'll take them batteries. They're worth, what, a quarter mil on the open market?
That priestess offered us a million. A quarter is only one third of that.
A quarter ain't a third.
A quarter is 25.
No.
We can't even buy a pair of boots with 25 units.
Enough! The point is, we ain't stupid enough to help kill the Guardians of the Galaxy. The whole dang Nova Corps be on us.
That ain't right. I just gotta say it this one time, Captain. No matter how many times Quill betrays you, you protect him like none of the rest of us much matter. Yeah. I'm the one what sticks up for you.
Take it easy, Craiglin.
Damn straight, lad. He's gone soft. Suppose it's time for a change in leadership. Oh.
Whoa!
There must be some kind of peaceful resolution to this, fellas. Or even a violent one, where I'm standing over there.
Welcome, everyone, to my world.
Wow. You have your own planet?
Moth. No larger than your Earth's moon.
Humility. I like it. I, too, am extraordinarily humble.
On a planet and can destroy 24 spaceships without a suit. What are you exactly?
I'm what's called a celestial, sweetheart.
A celestial like a god?
Small g, son. At least on the days I'm feeling humble as Drax. First thing I remember is flickering, adrift in the cosmos, utterly and entirely alone. Over millions of years, I learned to control the molecules around me. I grew smarter and stronger. And I continued building from there, layer by layer, the very planet you walk on now.
Whoa. But I wanted more. I desired. Meaning,
there must be some life out there in the universe, besides just me, I thought. And so, I set myself the task of finding it. I created what I imagined biological life to be like, down to the most minute detail.
Did you make a Venus?
Dude!
What is wrong with you?
If he's a planet, how could he make a baby with your mother? It would smush her. I don't need to hear how my parents. Why? My father would tell the story of impregnating my mother every winter solstice.
That's disgusting.
It was beautiful. You Earthers have hang-ups.
Yes, Drax? I got a penis.
Ha! Thank you.
That's not half bad. Oh. I've also got pain receptors and a digestive system and all the accompanying junk. I wanted to experience what it truly meant to be human as I set out amongst the stars. Till I found what I sought. Life. I was not alone in the universe after all.
When did you meet my mother?
Not long after. It was with Meredith that I first experienced love. I called her my river lily.
Oh.
from that love, Peter. You. I've searched for you for so long. And when I heard of a man from Earth who held an Infinity Stone in his hand without dying, I knew you must be the son of the woman I loved. If you loved her, why did you leave her?
Once again to glory with a new captain, Taser Face!
Wants to kill the fox herself, and he has bounties on his head in at least 12 Kree provinces. I assure you, I'm not as easy a mark as an old man without his magic stick or a talking woodland beast. I want 10% of the take. And a couple more things.
We got a whole box of hands if that one don't work out.
It is fine.
You, think them Kree is gonna execute the captain?
If the Kree consider themselves merciful, it will be painless.
Well, here it is. It's the best ship we got. Location of Ego's planet in the nav. We'll wire you the 10% once we've paid. What are you gonna do with your share?
As a child, my father would have Gamora and me battle one another in training. Every time my sister prevailed, my father would replace a piece of me with machinery, claiming he wanted me to be her equal. But she won. And again, and again, and again, never once refraining. So after I murder my sister, I will buy a warship with every conceivable instrument of death. I will hunt my father like a dog, and I will tear him apart slowly, piece by piece, until he knows some semblance of the profound and unceasing pain I know every single day.
Yeah,
was talking about, like, a pretty necklace. Or a nice hat, you know. Something make the other girls go, ooh, that's nice. Anyways, happy trails. My mother told everyone my father was from the stars. She had brain cancer, so everyone thought she was delusional.
Peter, listen, I'd love to believe all of this. I really would, but you left the most wonderful woman ever.
To die alone.
I didn't want to leave your mother, Peter.
If I don't return regularly to my planet and the light within it, this form will wither and perish.
So why didn't you come back? Why did you send Yondu, a criminal of all people, to come and defend you?
I loved your mother, Peter. I couldn't stand to set foot on an Earth where she wasn't living. You can't imagine what that's like.
I know exactly what that feels like. I had to watch her die. Over the millions and millions of years of my existence, I've made many mistakes, Peter. But you're not one of them. Please give me the chance to be the father she would want me to be. There's so much that I need to teach you about this planet and the light within. They are part of you, Peter.
What do you mean?
Give me your hand, son. Here. Hold them like that. Now, close your eyes and concentrate. Take your brain to the center of this planet.
Yes!
It's okay. Just relax. Concentrate. You can do it. Bring it back.
Yes!
Yes. Yes, now. Now shape it. Feel that energy. Yes. You're home. Peter. Get to this weird, dumb planet.
Ego found me in the larva state, orphan on my home world. He raised me by hand and kept me as his own.
So you're a pet?
I suppose.
People usually want cute pets. Why would Ego want such a hideous one?
I am hideous?
You are horrifying to look at, yes. But that's a good thing. When you're ugly and someone loves you, you know they love you for who you are. Beautiful people never know who to trust.
Well, then I'm certainly grateful to be ugly.
Those pools, they remind me of a time when I took my daughter to the forgotten leaves of my home world. She was like you.
Disgusting.
Innocent.
Drax, there's something I must tell you. What's going on?
This gross bug lady is my new friend.
I'm learning many things, like I'm a pet and ugly. You're not ugly, Drax.
What are you talking about?
Mantis, can you show us where we'll be staying? Why are there no other beings on this planet? The planet is Ego. A dog would not invite a flea to live on his back.
And you're not a flea?
I'm a flea with a purpose. I help him sleep.
What were you about to say to Drax before I walked out?
nothing. Your quarters are this way.
We deliver you to the Kree in the morning. Neither one of you will last much longer after that.
Okay, Taserface. Hey, tell the other guys we said hi, Taserface.
Oh, hey, what about this little plank? Can I smash it with a rock?
No, Jeff. It's too adorable to kill. Take it to the tailor.
No offense, but your employees are a bunch of jerks.
I was a Kree battle slave for 20 years when Stakar freed me. He offered me a place with the Ravagers. Said all I needed to do was adhere to the code. But I was young and greedy and stupid. Like you stealing those batteries.
That was mostly Drax.
Me and Stakar, the other captains, we weren't so different from you and your friends. The only family I ever had. But I broke the code. They exiled me. This is what I deserve.
Slow down, Drama Queen. You might deserve this, but I don't. We gotta get out of here.
Where's Quill?
Yeah, he went off with his old man.
Ego?
Yeah. It's a day for dumbass names. You smiled, and for a second I got a warm feeling, but then it was ruined by those disgusting-ass teeth.
You like a professional asshole or what?
Pretty much, bro. Why didn't you deliver Quill to Ego like you promised?
He was skinny. Could fit into places we couldn't. Good for thieving.
Uh-huh.
I got an idea on how to get out of here. But we're gonna need your little friend. That's my underwear.
Yeah, I was pretty sure he didn't know what you were talking about. You have to explain it more careful.
It's a prototype fit.
That's an Orlogan. It's a fin, Groot.
You explain it this time.
All right.
That's Vorker's eye. He takes it out when he sleeps. Go, look again.
But leave the eye here.
Why?
He's gonna wake up tomorrow,
and he's not gonna know where his eye is!
That's a desk. We told you it was this big. Tell me you guys have a refrigerator somewhere with a bunch of severed human toes. Okay, then let's just agree to never discuss this.
The drawer you want to open has this symbol on it, okay?
thinks you want him to wear it as a hat.
That's not what I said.
I'm Groot.
He's relieved you don't want him to.
I'm Groot.
He hates hats.
I'm Groot.
On anyone, not just himself.
I'm Groot.
One minute you think someone has a weird shaped head, the next minute it's just because you realize part of that head is the hat. That's why you don't like hats?
This is an important conversation right now.
Killed all my friends.
Get the third quadrant ready for release.
One more thing. You got any clones of Quill's old music on the ship?
Thank you.
I am sending you the coordinates for Yondu's ship.
Release the coordinate!
Aye, Captain!
I only ask one thing. That your High Priestess tell him the name of the man what sealed his fate. Taserface.
This could all be mine someday.
Rocket? Rocket, are you there? What are you doing, Peter?
Dance with me.
I'm not going to dance with you.
This is Sam Cooke, one of the greatest Earth singers of all time. Thinks you're not a dancer.
If you ever tell anyone about this, I will kill you.
When are we going to do something about this unspoken thing between us?
What unspoken thing?
This Cheers, Sam and Diane, guy and a girl on a TV show dig each other but never say it because if they do, the ratings would go down sort of thing.
There's no unspoken thing.
Well, it's a catch-22 because if you said it, then it would be spoken and you'd be a liar. So by not saying it, you aren't telling the truth and admitting that there is.
No, that's not what I've... What we should be discussing right now is something about this place that doesn't feel right.
What are you talking about? You're the one who wanted me to come here.
That girl Mantis, she's afraid of something.
Why are you trying to take this away from me?
I'm not trying
to... He's my father. He's blood.
Well, you have blood on Earth. You never wanted to return
again,
there.
Again, you made me come here. In Earth? Earth is the place where my mother died in front of me.
No, it's because that place is real, and this is a fantasy.
This is real. I'm only half human, remember?
That's the half I'm worried about.
Oh, I get it. You're jealous because I'm part God, and you like when I'm the weak one.
You were insufferable to begin with. I haven't been able to reach Rocket. I'm going to go outside. I'm going to try to get a signal.
You know what? This is not Cheers, after all. This is whatever the show is where one person is willing to open themselves up to new possibility and the other person is a jerk who doesn't trust anybody. It's a show that doesn't exist. That's why it would get zero ratings.
I don't know what Cheers is.
I finally found my family. Don't you understand that?
I thought you already had.
Psychopath. Skull and my arm from my body because of you.
You all right, son? I saw your girl stomp off a little earlier and went off.
Yeah. It's fortuitous you listening to this song.
You know, Brandy? My looking glass? A favorite of your mom's.
Yes. Yeah, it was.
One of Earth's greatest musical compositions. Perhaps its very greatest.
Yeah. Yes.
You know, Peter, you and I, we're the sailor in that song. He came on a summer's day, bringing gifts from far away. Like the child I put in your mother, or the freedom you brought Gamora. Brandy, you're a fine girl. What a good wife you would be. My life, my love, my lady is the sea. The sea calls the sailor back. He loves the girl, but that's not his place. Sea calls upon him as history calls upon great men. Sometimes we are deprived the pleasures of mortals.
Well, you may not be mortal, but me.
No, Peter. Death will remain a stranger to both of us as long as the light burns within the planet.
I'm immortal. Really?
Yes. Long as the light exists.
And I can use the light to build cool things like how you made this whole planet.
Well, it might take you a few million years of practice before you get really good at it. But yes.
What? This is... We'll get ready for an 800-foot statue of Pac-Man with Skeletor and Heather Locklear.
Do you want?
I'm gonna make some weird shit.
But you know, Peter, it is a tremendous responsibility. Only we can remake the universe. Only we can take the bridle of the cosmos and lead it to where it needs to go.
How?
Drax, we need to talk.
I'm sorry, but I like a woman with some meat on her bones.
What?
tried to let you down easily by telling you I found you disgusting.
No, that's not what I... What are you doing?
I'm imagining being with you physically.
Drax, that's not... I don't like you like that. I don't even like the type of thing you are.
Hey, there's no need to get personal.
Listen, Eco's gotten exactly what he wanted. I should have told you earlier. I'm stupid. You are in danger.
What is that?
Now, you need to readjust the way you process life. Everything around us, including the girl, everything is temporary. We are forever.
Doesn't eternity get boring?
Not if you have a purpose, Peter, which is why you're here. I told you how all those years ago I had an unceasing impulse to find life. But what I did not tell you was how, when I finally did find it, it was all so disappointing. And that is when I came to a profound realization. My innate desire to seek out other life was not so that I could walk among that life. Peter, I had found meaning.
Scared of all.
Shut up.
I know you steal batteries you don't need, and you push away anyone who's willing to put up with you, because just a little bit of love reminds you how big and empty that hole inside you actually is.
I said shut up.
I know them scientists what made you never gave a rat's ass about you.
I'm serious, dude.
Just like my own damn parents who sold me, their own little baby, into slavery. I know who you are, boy, because you're me. That's about to go fight a planet, I reckon.
All right. Okay, good. That's... Wait. Fight a what?
Who are you people? What is this place?
Gamora, let her go.
The bodies in the caverns. Who are they?
You are scared.
I call it the expansion. It is my purpose. Now, it is yours as well. It's beautiful. Over thousands of years, I implanted thousands of extensions of myself on thousands of worlds. I need to fulfill life's one true purpose. Grow and spread, covering all that exists until everything is me.
What did she do to me?
She already told me everything.
I only had one problem. A single celestial doesn't have enough power for such an enterprise. But two celestials, well now, that just might do.
bodies are his children.
Out of all my labors, the most beguiling was attempting to graft my DNA with that of another species. I hoped the result of such a coupling would be enough to power the expansion. I had Yondu deliver some of them to me. It broke the Ravager code, but I compensated him generously, and to ease his conscience, I said I'd never hurt them. And that was true. I mean, they never felt a thing. But one after the other, they failed me. Not one of them carried the celestial genes. Until you, Peter. Out of all my spawn, only you carried the connection to the light.
We need to find Peter now and get off this damn planet.
Ego will have won him to his side by now. He has a way.
Let me just go.
No. He's our friend.
All any of you do is yell at each other. You are not friends.
You're right. We're family. We leave no one behind. Except maybe you.
Oh my God.
For the first time in my existence, I am truly not alone!
What is it, son?
That's the mortal in you, Peter.
Yes.
We are beyond such things.
Yes.
Now.
But my mother. You said you loved my mother.
And that I did. My River Lily, who knew all the words to every song that came over the radio. I returned to Earth to see her 3 times. And I knew if I returned a 4th, I'd never leave. Expansion. Reason for my very existence would be over, so we did what I had to do. But it broke my heart to put that tumor in her head.
What?
No, no, all right. I know that sounds bad. Tried so hard to find the form
that suited you, and this is the thanks I get?
You really need to grow up. I wanted to do this together, but I suppose you'll have to learn by spending the next 1,000 years as a battery.
Finally. Rocket.
Keep that transmitter nearby so I can find you. We're in an old piece of construction equipment Yondu once used to slice open the bank of Ascavaria.
Ego's unhinged.
I know. Get ready.
Copper, Kraglin.
I told you something didn't feel right.
I
told you so. She's what I need to hear right now.
Well, I came back, didn't I?
Because there's an unspoken thing.
There is no unspoken thing.
What are you doing? You could have killed us all.
Thank you, Rocket.
We had it under control.
We did not. That is only an extension of his true self. He will be back soon.
What's Corvette doing here?
Whatever I need to do to get a damn ride home.
She tried to murder me.
I saved you, you stupid fox.
He's not a fox.
I'm Groot.
I'm not a raccoon either.
I am Groot.
Raccoon, whatever.
How do we kill a celestial?
There's a center to him. His brain, his soul, whatever it is. Some sort of protective shell.
It's in the caverns below the surface.
Yondu?
I guess I should be glad I was a skinny kid, otherwise you'd have delivered me to this maniac.
You still reckon that's the reason I kept you around, you idiot?
That's what you told me, you old doofus.
Well, once I figured out what happened to them other kids, I wasn't just gonna hand you over.
You said you were gonna eat me.
That was being funny.
Not to me.
You people have issues.
Well, of course I have issues. That's my freaking father.
Just as a backup.
Seriously can't believe that's where your mind goes.
It's just a random thought, man. I thought we were friends.
Of course I care about the planets and the buildings and all the animals on the planets. And the people.
The Krabby Puppy's so cute, he makes me want to die.
Below the surface of the planet. Dive!
Genetic connection to the light to help destroy the universe. Try to teach me how to control power.
So could you?
A little. I made a ball.
A ball?
I thought as hard as I could. It was all that I could come up with.
You thought? You think when I make the Zero fly, I use my head?
Rocket.
I got it covered.
We must hurry. It will not take Ego long to find us.
Keep it steady.
We drill into the center, we kill him.
Hey, remember that Aisha chick?
Yeah, why? Oh, hell! fire to blaring the lasers!
They blew out the generator! I think I packed a small detonator!
A detonator is worthless without explosives!
Well, we got these!
Is that thing strong enough to kill Ego?
If it is, it'll cause a chain reaction throughout his entire nervous system.
Meaning what?
The entire planet will explode. We'll have to get out of here fast. I rigged the timer.
Go!
He's coming.
Didn't you say you could make him sleep?
When he won't. He's too powerful. I can't.
You don't have to believe in yourself. Because I believe in you.
Please!
I never thought she'd be able to do it. With as weak and skinny as she appears to be.
I don't know how long I can hold him.
The metal's too thick. For the bomb to work, we'd actually need to place it on Ego's core. And our fat butts ain't gonna fit through those tiny holes.
Well, that's a terrible idea.
Which is the only kind of idea we have left.
Unbelievable. Rock it, do this! Rock it, do that!
What a day.
First you flick this switch, then this switch. That activates it. Then you push this button, which will give you 5 minutes to get out of there. Now, whatever you do, don't push this button. Because that will set off the bomb immediately, and we'll all be dead. Now, repeat back what I just said.
I'm Groot.
Uh-huh.
I'm Groot.
That's right.
I'm Groot.
No! No, that's the button that will kill everyone! Try again.
I'm Groot.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Groot?
Uh-huh.
I'm Groot.
No! That's exactly what you just said! How is that even possible? Which button is the button you're supposed to push? Point to it. No!
Hey, you're making him nervous!
Shut up and give me some tape! Does anybody have any tape out there? I want to put some tape over the death button.
I don't have any tape. Let me check. Yo, Yondu! Do you have any...
Single person has tape.
Nope.
Did you ask Nebula?
Yes.
Are you sure?
I asked Yondu and she was sitting right next to him.
I knew you were lying.
You have priceless batteries and an atomic bomb in your bag. If anybody's gonna have tape, it's you.
That's exactly my point. I have to do everything.
You are wasting a lot of time here.
Guardians, perhaps it will provide you solace that your deaths are not without curse. They will serve as a warning to all of those tempted to betraying us. Don't screw with the Sovereign.
This is gonna hurt.
Promises, promises.
What?
You look like Mary Poppins.
Is he cool?
Hell yeah, he's cool.
I'm Mary Poppins, y'all!
How long till the bomb goes off?
In the unlikely event the Groot doesn't kill us all, about 6 minutes.
Franklin, we need the quadrant for an extraction. T-minus 5 minutes.
All right, Captain. Somebody's got to be up top when Kraglin arrives. Drax, take Mantis.
Oh, my nipples!
Let you make this choice.
Thank you.
told you, I don't want to do this alone. You cannot deny the purpose the universe has bestowed upon you.
Squish my Walkman.
Spacesuit and an arrow rig. I only have one of each.
I am Groot.
What's that?
He says, welcome to the frickin' Guardians of the Galaxy. Only he didn't use frickin'. We're gonna need to have a real discussion about your language.
Thank you.
Where's Peter? Rocket, where is he? Rocket. Rocket, look at me! Where is he? No. I'm not leaving without him.
I'm sorry. I can only afford to lose one friend today.
Raglan, go!
Wait. Skoldak. Rocket, where's Quill? Rocket! Where's Quill? I told Gamora how, when I was a kid, I used to pretend David Hasselhoff was my dad. He's a singer and actor from Earth, really famous guy. Earlier, it struck me. Yondu didn't have a talking car, but he did have a flying arrow. He didn't have the beautiful voice of an angel, but he did have the whistle of one. Both Yondu and David Hasselhoff went on kick-ass adventures and hooked up with hot women. And fought robots. I guess David Hasselhoff did kind of end up being my dad after all. Only it was you, Yondu. I had a pretty cool dad. What I'm trying to say here is, sometimes that thing you're searching for your whole life, it's right there by your side all along. You don't even know it.
Nebula. child like you. I was concerned with staying alive until the next day, every day. And I never considered what Thanos was doing to you. I'm trying to make it right. There are little girls like you across the universe who are in danger. You can stay with us and help them.
I will help them by killing Thanos.
I don't know if that's possible. You will always be my sister.
Kevin found this for you in a junker shop. Said you'd come back to the fold someday. What is it? It's called a Zune. It's what everybody's listening to on Earth nowadays. It's got 300 songs on it.
300 songs?
Wait. Rocket, grab the pieces and reassemble them. I think Yondu would want you to have it. Thanks. Come.
It's not time to make a change. Just relax, take it easy. You're still young, that's your fault. There's so much you have to know. Find a girl, settle down. If you want, you can marry. Look at me, I am old, but I'm happy. I was once like you are now.
They
and
came.
I know that it's not easy to be calm when you found something going on.
What is it?
But take your time.
I sent word to Yondu's old ravager buddies and told them what he did.
Everything you've got, but you will still
it's a ravager funeral.
But your dreams may not. How can I try to explain? When I do, he turns away again. It's always been the same old story. From the moment I could talk, I was ordered.
He didn't let us down after all, Captain.
A way.
No, he did not, son.
I know that I
he did
have
not.
To go away. I know I have to go.
Fairly well.
I will see you in the stars.
He didn't chase him away.
No.
Even though he yelled at him, that was always mean. And he stole batteries he didn't need.
Well, of course not.
Find a girl,
it's just
settle down if you want
it's an unspoken thing.
Can marry,
shame that it took the tragedy of losing Yondu to bring us all together again. But I think he'd be proud knowing that we're back as a team.
I'm in. Help.
I miss you guys so much.
Hell yes.
What's that? We steal some shit.
Priestess, the council is waiting.
They are perturbed. I've wasted our resources. When they see what I have created here, their wrath will dissipate.
It's a new type of birthing pod, man?
That, my child, is the next step in our evolution. More powerful, more beautiful, more capable of destroying the Guardians of the Galaxy. I think I should call him Adam.
Sequoia. The two of them walk by, people say, oh boy. They ask me why I'm bringing a baby into battle that's really irresponsible and getting them rattled. I say, give me a break. Get off of my back, damn it. I didn't learn parenting. My daddy was a planet.
Oh, dude. Seriously? You gotta clean up your room. It's a complete mess.
I am Groot.
I'm not boring. You're boring. You know what's boring? Sitting there playing that mind-numbing game. What's boring is me.